ain't no gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Craft Farms here, and as I said, I do some video while I'm at the farm. I'm at the farm right now. I'm currently sitting in the Duramax, waiting on my dad to get here with the rake. We went and picked up the rake, and then a good family friend, he helps out with haying in the summer, and he's cutting in the field that I'm sitting in right now. So I brought him up to the mower, and he's currently cutting behind me. He just went down the hill. Otherwise, I'd show you guys. But so yeah, I'm just sitting here. My dad's bringing the Deutz and the V-Rake up here. So I'm just gonna sit here and listen to some music and wait, and I'll pick up once I see him coming up over the hill here. He shouldn't be too terribly long. He wasn't too terribly far behind us. So, I'll either pick up when the mower gets back by me, or else when the rake comes. So I'll see you guys in just a sec. So I don't know how well you guys can see it. Especially if I have my finger in the way. But right there's Deutz and my dad making his way over here. It's not as far away as it looks in the camera, but I don't know why it's so far back. It won't let me zoom in either, so I don't know what the deal is there. But yeah, actually, give me just a second. I know what I can do. There we go. I switched to using my camera app rather than using the YouTube capture app. And let's find the tractor. It's behind the crack. Okay. Sorry for it being a little shaky. My hand's very unsteady right now. So yeah, there's the tractor and the rake. I'm going to have to stop because I got to get out and talk to my dad. Because the Duramax is low on fuel. The low fuel light's on. So, be back in a second with something else. Alright guys, so sorry that I didn't get more footage for you guys. Most of our day was spent fixing my dad's 4430. I'll show you guys that here in a little bit. And then fixing the baler, and then we were baling. I did get a little bit of footage from baling, as you saw. But Adam. Clogged throat. As you guys saw, I did get some footage of baling, but the field we were in, let me get in the shade here. The field we were in is really hilly and really bumpy, so it's kind of hard to film. but I did get some stuff. I'm just going out right now taking pictures of some equipment to model up and in game for Farm Sim. Just finished taking pictures of the 4400 versatile swather over there, and I'm standing right next to another piece of equipment. Give me just a second, I'll flip the camera around. So I'm standing right next to our BR780 New Holland Round Baler and my uncle's 2290 case. Like I said, just finished with the 4400. Not sure if I'm going to do the 1270 or not. I'm going to do our Hay Hiker 1400, because that'd be a fun addition to farm some, and then we got some Vermeer balers over there that I'm going to do as well. And as I'm going through taking pictures, I'll show you guys some of the equipment. So yeah, this is our one of our balers. We have another New Holland baler. It's a New Holland 660, which is the one that we were using yesterday in the footage that you saw from baling. So I'm going to go ahead and take some pictures of the 2290 here because that's what I want to make. Not sure if I'm going to do the baler or not. If I do, I'll come back another time and take pictures of that. I'm just driving around in my dad's Kawasaki Brute Force ATV. We call them four-wheelers. V-Twin 650. I'm going to make one of these as well. And then make our Ranger. But the Ranger sitting in the yard. And I'll do this when I get back into the yard. And some other stuff as well. So I'm going to go ahead and take pictures of the tractor here. And I'll be back with you guys when I get over to the balers. We'll walk over here, I guess, before I quit. And show you guys the hay hiker. This is what we've used to haul all 2,000 of our bales last year, and we used it some the year before. We're now using this in replace of the semi. It has a, I think it's a 12 or 14, I think it's 12 bale capacity. You just drive up, bale goes back to this plate here, lift it up, and this blue piece for when the bale, let me climb up here. When the bale goes on that side, this blue piece comes up to this bar, and then the bale goes all the way over to that side. But when the bale goes right where I'm standing, that blue piece just stays still. And once you have two bales on there, where's the kicker at? There's the kicker, the big blue piece. That's usually all the way up here at the front. Once you have your two bales on the front, you'll push it back to about here or so. And then you'll just keep doing that until you got bales all the way down here. And then to unload it, you just push it all the way down. This thing does lift. It lifts up at an angle. Okay, I'm going to get down from here now. So this thing would be a lot of fun to have. It's a Hay Hiker 1400. So I'm going to go ahead and take pictures of these two things, and I'll be back with you guys when I get over to the balers. Okay, so I'm just taking a momentary pause from taking pictures of the tractor, and I'm walking over here. So this is where I got my inspiration to do the Mighty Handy cake feeder, because we have one. We haven't used it lately. My uncle has a gravity wagon that we use now. But yeah, this is where I got the inspiration for it from. And if we go over here, this is kind of the dead row. We have a 1066. We have a, I think it's a 1466 or else another 1066, sitting in the yard. That's my uncle's old tractor. And if we walk over here, this was an incident we had a couple years ago. This was a 1086, I believe. Yeah, it was one of our many 1086s. And it was plugged in at night and it burnt up. We have another 2290 that is actually out cutting right now that was sitting right next to that tractor, and that did start on fire too. But that one was salvageable. It basically burnt from the front end all the way back to the cab. So we had to buy a new hood, fix some wires, fix a bunch of stuff on the engine. I think we had to buy new tires on the front. That one doesn't have the duals on, but that is currently out on the Rouse, one of the two Rouse 18-foot double sickle mowers. And then the Deutz Alice 7120 with the 18-wheel V-rake. And then the the family friend's running the sickle mower, which you guys saw a short little snippet of it yesterday before he went over the hill. And then the rake, which you guys saw that I was sitting waiting for my dad to bring. We didn't rake. My grandpa's out raking. And then we came back and did some more work on his tractor, my dad's tractor. And then we did some work on the baler. because there was a band that broke, and so we had to put a new band on. My dad had to do some welding, and then we had to do a couple other things on it. And and then that's hooked to one of the 1086s, and that's out bailing. That's what my dad's doing right now. But I figured we're going to be leaving here in a couple hours, so I better get my pictures taken. So I'm going to get back to that, and I'll see you guys when I get to the baler. So I got pictures of the tractor and pictures of the swather. I'm going to have to kind of slow down because my SD card's starting to get full. So I'm not going to take pictures of the hay hiker or these balers yet. I'm going to be here plenty other times so I can get pictures of these when I need it. So we have two Vermeers. We have a 605K, which is sitting right here. I don't think these have been used at all this year. I think they've just been using the New Hollands. I guess I can look. This says 600 on the counter, but it's a busted counter. And then we have a 605J here. I'm going to make both of these balers in the future. Just like I said, can't take too many more pictures now. And I want to get pictures of like my dad's 4430 and some of that kind of stuff. So yeah, that's the balers. I'll go over here to the swather and I'll see you guys in just a sec. Okay, so first off, here's the some of you might have heard me talking about the calf chute that my dad bought before branding this year. This is it. It's awesome. This thing works so slick. All you do is you put your foot on here and push it down, and then that'll unlatch. I think the latch is on, yeah, the latch is on this side here. It'll unlatch this, and then this thing just spins either way. It is so nice. So you just, oh, I got a runny nose. All you gotta do is you take these three bolts off to take the hitch off, and then you take, let's see, because that bolt there loosens all of this so it can spin. And then on the back here, there's another bolt like it. There's supposed to be one right there. I don't know why there isn't. And then you just take the two tires off using this little tool here. It fits right into these slots. And then you just lift up, pull these pins, off goes the tire, and it drops to the ground. It's very awesome. So then here's our Versatile 4400. There's another swather sitting behind me a ways. I think it's another 4400 or else a 4000. The only difference is it's cabless. And it's just one wheel steer in the back. This thing I don't think's run in 2 years now. Because I haven't had much of a use for swathers. So there's the inside. I got a bunch of pictures of this. I know one of these swathers is a gas engine. I don't know if it's this one or the other one. But, yeah. And then here's our 1270. There's kind of a funny story behind this one. So this thing has a broken steering plate, which is why it's missing the front tire. And you can see it's sitting up on a bunch of blocks. Well, there was one time this thing started itself and hopped off the block. I'm not exactly sure where the steering plate is or what's broken. But, yeah, this is what we use when we grind hay a lot. We'll use this to load the grinder. I'll get over to the grinder here in a little bit. And you guys will see it. Yeah, this thing has no door anymore. It broke off. So I'm going to go over by where like my dad's swather and the grinder and stuff is and see what's down there that I want to get some pictures of that I want to make in the near future. I do have to keep in mind that I have to save space for the four-wheeler and the Ranger here. But yeah, so I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, so can't get into the hay corral. The gate's shut and I think there's a couple cows in there or something. I don't know, I don't want to mess with the gate. But over here, here's a 5020 John Deere. That thing hasn't run in a long time. Last time it ran, a bunch of the wires around the starter started on fire. Over there, you can see our Steiger. That's used for the oats field over there. Try and break stuff up. We've been dumping our manure in there for the last few years. Because the alfalfa doesn't want to take off over there. So we've just been putting oats in there. Starting last year, we put oats in there. I don't know where... Oh, the MacDon. We have a MacDon conditioner, but that's sitting up the road a couple miles. So I ain't going to get over to that. Here's some of our hay. But most of it's all down there. Let's see if I can... Oh, actually, there's not a lot of hay left. But, yeah, so I'm going to go over to my dad's tractor and might get some pictures of that. We'll see. So, yeah. Let's see. What else is in the yard? Oh, just my dad's tractor. We have the International in the yard. But I'm not going to show too much of the yard. But I'll see you guys at my dad's tractor. Alright, so this here's my dad's 4430. My number one favorite tractor on this farm, mainly because it's John Deere, and it's one that we use. And it is taken apart a lot right now because we've been trying to work on it. It won't start, and we're not sure why. My dad bought all new relays for it. And then it still wouldn't start, so he bought a brand new starter. Well, it was a rebuilt starter. This step he put on last year, because my grandpa has bad knees, and this, I think, ran the baler last year that my grandpa ran. So my dad bought a new step, and this is a much nicer step, too. But there's a relay up under here under the hood, and we're not getting power to that. So that's the only thing that we're not getting power to. All the other relays work. So we're not getting power from that relay down to the starter. And so, so my dad's thinking that's the issue. He's gonna put the old relay back in and see if that works. It did come with 3-point arms. We took them off, just after we got it up here. I had completely forgotten that this thing even had 3 points. On it. The guy that we bought it from, he used it for his raking tractor. So I came up here and ran baler. It's a very nice tractor. I really like it. And I'm going to try and make this thing, especially because I can get a lot of detailed pictures. I know there's some 4440s out there and a lot of nice tractors, especially the ones that TMJD Modding did. That are released on 9560R Modding on Facebook. Those things, he did a 4840 and a 4440. Those things are awesome. He did a great job on them. There is a 4440 out on American Eagle's Modding, which is what he used as the base. Then he did some work to them in Blender. And yeah, I don't think that we have duals for this. I don't know. I don't think the guy ever put duals on it. So yeah, you can see 4430. Very nice tractor. Give me a second. I'll climb on up in here. Show you guys the interior of this. Man, it's hot in here. So you can see we have this tore open and a bunch of other stuff. Yeah, this is the 4430. I really like this tractor. So you can see in the barn or the shop is my uncle's New Holland TD 5050 tractor. It's hooked to the neighbor's baler because he's got to put all brand new bearings in it. The guy he bought it from, it needed a lot of work. I got a runny nose. So yeah, he's got that in our shop, because he didn't quite know where to start with it. If we look over there, you can see our cattle trailer hooked to the Peterbilt. I'm going to do our cattle trailer, maybe our Peterbilt, but I'm not going to do the Pete anytime soon. But yeah, so I'm going to go find something else to look at and see what else I can show you guys. And I'll probably go over to the Peterbilt and the gravity wagon and show you guys them. So I'll be back in a sec. So here's our Peterbilt. I'm not sure what model it is. But it's a Peterbilt. It's a very nice truck. It's got a few dings and dents on it, but what piece of farm equipment doesn't? So then this is our cattle trailer. It's a ground load. And like I said, I'm going to make one of these. I'm not going to do it right. Well, maybe I'll work on it soon for when we get into beef on Dad's farm. Because you guys requested beef. So let me climb up here. Show you guys. I climbed up the wrong tire. There's nothing to see here. So yeah, this is the trailer. It's a nice long trailer. Here's one of our Bobcats. We have three. This is the 753. We have a S650 and an S, another S. It's an older one though, but yeah. So here we have an old grain truck that hasn't moved in years. They don't use them anymore since they don't do crops. But give me just a sec, here, guys. Hey guys. So this is the ending to the farming video. I had been hoping to do more video, but my phone died on me, and then I had to help my grandma with something, and then we had to get ready to go, so I didn't get a chance. I was going to show you guys the Rangers, but didn't get to it today. Maybe next time I'm up there, I'll show those. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm going to try and do as many more of those as I can. So this is the outro. Hopefully this video turns out well. It was recorded on my phone, so it might be a little sucky, but I can't help it. I'm going to get to editing this thing right now. So I'm going to get this thing uploaded as soon as I possibly can. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up button for me. And if you're new to the channel, make sure that you subscribe. If you are subscribed already or are planning to subscribe, make sure that you turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time, Saturdays at noon. Although tomorrow, or I guess by the time you see this, you'll have seen the other video, and that one was out at 2 rather than noon. So make sure you check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, my mod website, as well as some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.